Hi friends, welcome back to Sheena's Homestead. Today is a special day. We are going to one of my favorite places in the entire world. No, it's not Eagle River, Wisconsin, but it still has to do with nature. We are going to a nursery, and this one is quite a ways from our house, but I love making the trip out there. As you can see in the back mirror here, or the window, it's just beautiful scenery and wide open spaces. And it's really nice, right, Jeff?
Absolutely.
So our goal here is we're looking for three trees. Of course, they're fruit trees, so we're not sure if we're going to go with a couple apple and maybe a peach, or if we just go all apple. One of my goals is to start purchasing different fruit trees that bloom at different times of the year. So the goal is to find something that maybe lasts a little further into winter so that we can store these apples for a longer period of time. So hopefully we can find somebody there who can help us out a little bit, and you never know what else we'll find. Okay, so we're here. We just pulled in, and I already want one of everything. Yeah. Too much gene. It's the too much gene, but take a look. These hydrangeas are just beautiful. And in case you didn't know, hydrangeas also come in tree form, and the bees and pollinators love them, as you can see. Another set. Ah, and here we are in the fruit tree section. You can see these trees here are such good quality. They even come with fruit on them already. Quite amazing. So for instance, this is a red Fuji. It's only 57. It's really well priced. So you can see there's just different varieties here. This one says it's a small fruit. It's extremely cold hardy, which, I mean, for here that's great, but it says quite small fruit. I don't know. I think we're looking for something a little bigger. So here we have some pear varieties. I mean, look at this one already. That's more pears than the one we have at home. And then there are some plums as well. This one is a Fuji apple. This tree looks pretty healthy. I think we might end up going with that. What are these? Lime crisp apple. I don't know. Which way are we gonna go?
Apple.
Apple.
I'm an apple guy.
Yeah, I think so too. Oh, here's peaches though. Almost ate a bug. I mean, there's no peaches on these, but they do look like healthy trees. How much are these? Poly peach. $57.95. Saturn peach. You think apple?
Apple.
Okay. Let's go back to the apple.
How about this one? Triumph apple.
I've never heard that.
Me neither. Let's find out more about it. Pleasantly tart and well-balanced red apple with good storage life. Excellent for fresh eating, blooms mid-season, harvest fruit in late September. Okay, resistant to apple scab.
Yeah. I don't even know what apple scab is.
Me neither. I think it's bad though.
I think so too.
Yeah.
I love the color of this one too.
It's nice.
And the low branches. I think these would be great for photography too because of the low branches. Should we try one?
We shall. How about these two?
Excellent. Okay, so we've found a Jonathan apple, and it's literally loaded with apples already. What I like about that one, though, is that it ripens in late October. Late October or early October, did it say?
It says...
I think early.
Early October.
Early October. I like that because then we're getting a harvest at a different time of year. All the other ones we have are mostly August, September-ish. So I think that might be our third choice.
This is a good one.
Okay.
Just have to plant it a little more straight. We're good.
Oh, it's just bending over because it has so much fruit.
It is.
We'll have to put one of those stakes that you do.
A little support.
Yeah. That's not anything you can't handle.
Exactly. We'll take it.
Okay, so now that we have that all picked out and settled, I'm going to do a little shopping. This little area is so cool. They have a lot of really neat and unique things for the garden. Let me show you. I love this bench so much. Not the spider so much, but the tray bench. It's so beautiful. Look how pretty their garden hook is. Oh, these would be darling in some Christmas pictures. Oh. Oh, hello there, sir. Oh my gosh. Now that is just so beautiful. The color on that. Oh my goodness. Look at how well these are all doing here. I can't believe all of this fruit grew out of one little pot like that. I wouldn't think that it could get that much nutrition in order to produce all that. It's insane and so beautiful. Look at this. I love greenhouses. They're just so fresh and pretty, and the light is so clear and crisp in here. I love it. I've loved it since I was a little kid, but I like being here even more as each passing year goes by. I guess that I am just truly a plant person. I mean, look at these. are just insane. Definitely getting towards the end of the season on some of these, but look how gorgeous. So, you know that at home we have purple coneflower, which is echinacea. These are echinacea too, and they're absolutely beautiful, and they spread on their own. So we're gonna get these, and we're gonna use them to make our own tincture. Okay, I think we're ready. Hey guys, my biggest weakness in the world since I was born. Baskets! I don't know, I think it's genetic because my mom likes that kind of stuff too. But, or, you know, maybe it's just part of being a woman. We're the gatherers and we need something to gather in. So, oh my gosh, these are all so pretty. Well, all in all, we are really happy with our purchase, and I think Rob got off a little bit easy. There's so many things here that I want. We'll be back next time, and I think we'll get some hydrangeas for the side of our house, and just maybe some more pretty things instead of just the useful things. But thank you so much for following along with me today. I hope you enjoyed our little garden tour of our favorite nursery, and I hope you have a great and blessed weekend. Bye, friends. We'll see if this little guy makes it all the way home. Okay, ride safe.